practice teaching talk.
Then condition ourselves before we go into detail of today's asana, what we are going to learn. Please close your eyes, sit in any comfortable pose. Imagine yourself to be a 7-day camper. Have some knowledge of yoga.
The legs.
Abdomen held in normal contour. Place your hands respectively above the thighs and knees, wherever it's comfortable. Normal breathing. Passively observe your breath. Your mind may wander, but bring it back to breath. Slowly come out of the asana. Stretch your legs forward. Rotate your ankles, toes, clockwise, anti-clockwise, forward, backward. Tap your legs and come out of the asana. Thank you. Let's all practice doing asana. Vajrasana. Knees together, toes together, cavities form, sit. Slowly sit. If you are uncomfortable, kindly come out of the asana. Massage your ankles or knees wherever you have pain. Observe. Close your eyes or gaze at a fixed point. Whichever is comfortable for you. Be in this pose, state of mind, as far as possible. Always check yourself that knees are together, because when we focus on our breath, we tend to lose our grip. The posture sure benefits our lower back and increases blood circulation in our lower abdomen. Kindly open your eyes. Come out of the asana. Stretch your leg forward. Tap your legs. Ankles and toes moving forward, backward. Rotate them clockwise, anti-clockwise. What benefits? It is very good for postural fixity, corrects our postural defects, improves digestion due to blood circulation is more, then good for constipation, relieves constipation, good for blood, good for digestive system, stomach disorders, sciatica, acidity, severe back problem and spinal disorders. Enables flexibility to our lower limbs, relaxes our thighs, tones our muscles, hip, thighs and calves. It cures joint pains, urinary disorders. While performing this asana, it makes us calm and our nerves get relaxed. Continuous performing this asana, due to slow and rhythmic breathing, it induces us to go in meditative state. Our mind is focused, increases awareness, being in the present, concentration improves. Many more things we learn while performing this asanas. Increases more patience on us. We observe ourselves more. I usually do this pranayama. I usually do this asana while doing my pranayams. It helps me, as it calms me down by giving good support for my back. I can concentrate more on my breathing technique. I can concentrate on its breathing and it helps me to perform very well. I can focus on it. And one more thing, if I have food heavy, so that time also I sit. Anytime this asana, anytime we can sit. Now, initially start with 2 minutes to 5 minutes. Max you can sit to 30 minutes. Max to your capacity. Any questions please?
One. obviously this is the only exercise which can be done after meal. And normally also you can perform because it is very good for our stretching of our leg muscles, exercise for our leg muscles. Anything else? Hope you'll enjoy doing this asana. Till we meet next, share your experiences.